I'm honestly really hungry. I have no idea how I'm gonna get through this video. Let's give it a crack though, shall we? Donuts are traditionally shaped as thick circular doughs with a hole in the middle, the official term for which is called a toroid. Planets, on the other hand, are balls with many layers, at the center of which lies a core. We're spherical. But what if planets were toroids? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your hungry host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if Earth was shaped like a donut? I don't know why that image of Homer from The Simpsons after he sells his soul to the devil and then has his head shaped like a donut keeps popping into my head, but you know, it's kind of irrelevant. Forget that image. It has nothing to do with the video. Before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys, what is your favorite type of donut? Shout out to my mate Caroline, who regularly goes donutting with me. I think my favorite would controversially have to be a filled donut, glazed and filled with something kind of like lemony and creamy. Damn it, I'm hungry again. Leave me your thoughts and hit that thumbs up button and show you like our content. Also, if you don't yet have notifications turned on, what are you doing? You don't want to miss out on all of the clever things we have to say. So, what if the Earth was shaped like a donut? While this question sounds crazy, in terms of physics, a donut-shaped world is actually possible, although much less likely to work long-term than a spherical world because it would be so much less stable. So what if the Earth was shaped like a donut? Firstly, our planet currently works because the core of the Earth is so dense it draws its matter in. That's the way gravity kind of works. A donut planet could work without the dense core if it was spinning fast enough. Basically, it would work in the way that water doesn't fall out of a bucket if you spin it around fast enough. Gravity. Cool. While that sounds like it would make you pretty dizzy, no worries, you actually probably wouldn't feel it. Earth is already moving at 1,000 miles per hour as it is. Because we're so small and the Earth is so big, we're none the wiser. However, it would affect the duration of our Earth's day significantly. Humans and wildlife alike are pretty in tune with our Earth's day and night schedule. By and large, we're awake during sunlight hours and asleep during our night hours. On the donut Earth, the day would be 2.84 hours long. So light, then dark, then light again, then dark. It would be a barrage of sunrises and sunsets. Had we evolved on a donut Earth, maybe this wouldn't vex us, but as animals that love structure, this would be very weird to say the least. So the lighting states don't get any better towards the inner of the donut, where people may see polar nights for half the year. Although with visible Earth rising around the ring, there is more surface area to reflect light when it's shining, meaning at times this would be the brightest place to be. Because of the shape of the Earth, life would be very different depending on where on the donut you lived. The gravity just inward of the poles would be the greatest, and it would be the weakest at the equator. On Earth, we can't feel too much gravitational difference, but on donut Earth, we absolutely would. It would also likely be hotter at the poles too. If we're talking topography, it seems the new Earth shape would likely cause mountainous regions around the rim of the donut hole. Apparently, these would be pretty huge too. We're talking much bigger than Everest. I wonder if we could try and fly planes through the middle of the planet. It might be fun and more efficient. But what would the change in Earth shape mean for gravity? It actually turns out that gravity may be the least of our problems when it comes to air travel. Now, because of the shape of the donut Earth and its need to spin super fast to remain intact, Earth would experience some very, very, very intense weather. There would be wild and raging winds, huge storms, and massive fluctuations of temperature depending on where you lived. It would make travel and day-to-day living pretty difficult and inconsistent. Back in the times of seafaring, can you imagine jumping on a ship and discovering America? I don't think so. You know how we all love a bit of GPS? Well, get ready to get lost, because satellites wouldn't really work too well with our new Earth shape. They wouldn't orbit in the way that they do now. And speaking of orbit, say goodbye to our beautiful moon. What would this mean for the tides? Well, the whole new shape of the Earth has changed, so legit, who even really knows what's going on at this point? So I guess the takeaway from this should be like, whoa, donut-shaped planets could exist, but they're very improbable and living on one would be pretty intense because they're very, very, very volatile. I'm honestly pretty happy with our spherical Earth. It basically does the trick, right? Final thought, do you think that out there somewhere there's a band of donut earthers, like flat earthers? If you are a donut earther, come at me. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this answer. What would you do on donut Earth? Also, don't forget to tell me what your favorite donut is too, because that is very important information. Before I go, I just want to read a couple of comments from one of my most recent videos I made, which was called What If the Sun Went Out for 24 Hours? And this is what you had to say. Jupiter Weebly-D said, I love the sun. Mate, Me too. Come back, sun. It's winter right now and I'm cold. Grey World wrote, a black sun sounds interesting. Doesn't it just? And Noelia wrote, what if we could live in the sun? Ooh, that's a good suggestion. We should turn that into a video. So guys, please do leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend who finds answers to crazy questions like this fun and engaging. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.